Hello, my fellow STEEMers and YouTubers. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies. So according to CoinMarketCap, Bitcoin is trading at the moment at the level of $3,920. So almost no change. It has been trading sideways for the last few days. The same holds for Ethereum, XRP, let's say Litecoin, EOS, and etc. So most of the cryptocurrencies, they have been trading sideways for the last few days. Now let's have a look at the price of STEEM. So this is the site of hobby, and I usually, when I do this technical and candlestick analysis, I use this exchange. But as I said earlier, we have a new very beautiful exchange for the STEEM blockchain ecosystem, freedomx.io, and very soon when there will be enough liquidity on this exchange, I will use its charts to conduct this cryptocurrency market analysis. So now let's switch to the chart of STEEM. So this is a 4-hour chart or time frame. Just to remind you, a few days ago, a couple of times, we discussed that at the levels of the previous tops or highs on the chart, it is between 40 cents and 45 cents, we have some kind of resistance level. So it used to be a resistance level. At the moment, we saw that the price of our beloved cryptocurrency STEEM broke through this resistance line, and it reached yesterday approximately 50 cents. So it was trading for a certain time yesterday at levels a little bit higher than 49 cents or 49.5 cents. So a few hours ago on a one-way chart, if we switch, the price of STEEM dropped a little bit, so it retraced a little bit, and after reaching this previously resistance line, at the moment we can consider it as a support line because of the breakthrough, the price just rebounded again. So in my view, I'm not pretty sure that at the moment we will have this solid rebound, because let me show some interesting statistics. So according to some interesting statistics provided by Solki Steemian, according to his latest report, the levels of the liquid STEEM that are the liquid STEEM that is stored on the cryptocurrency exchanges, such as, for example, you can have a look at his charts, such as Binance, Bittrex, and etc., is at almost its all-time high. So at the moment, this is the orange line, we can see that the liquid STEEM stored on the cryptocurrency exchanges is over 100 millions. Last year, for example, in March or in the first half of the year, usually 75 millions of liquid STEEM used to be stored on a daily basis on the cryptocurrency exchanges. At the moment, this level is relatively high according if compared to the levels that we used to have last year. So that's why I think the price of STEEM will fluctuate within these levels, and we will not have a very, very solid rebound. I mean, even if we see some kind of rebound, we will see after that some kind of retracement, because in my view, some of those people who store their liquid STEEM on the cryptocurrency exchanges, if the price of STEEM goes higher, they will start selling their liquid STEEM. That's why they withdrawn their STEEM within this period. This is the last few months of the previous year, and this is the beginning of 2019. So I'm pretty sure that if the price of STEEM goes a little bit higher, it will trigger this sell-off, because many people at the moment, they are waiting probably for better prices. They are storing their liquid STEEM on the exchanges, and if they see some beautiful prices, they may start selling their STEEM. So keep in mind that we may see some retracement very soon, and but it is not that bad, because even if we see some retracement, I am very happy if the price of STEEM will be over the level of 40 cents, at least over the level of 40 cents in the next, let's say, few weeks. I will be really very happy if the price of STEEM doesn't retrace lower. So this is what I wanted to outline today about the STEEM price. Now let's switch to some interesting news. For example, yesterday I saw in Twitter very interesting message that the company BlockFi or BlockFi started providing cryptocurrency loans, and at the moment it means that they use your cryptocurrency Bitcoin, Ether and Litecoin as a collateral for those loans, so you can get some loans in US dollars, for example, or in some other fiat currencies, and as a collateral they will accept cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin, Ether, and yesterday or a few days ago they added Litecoin. So I'm really very happy when I see the mass adoption of cryptocurrency in the financial system, in the global financial system. It has been constantly expanding, more and more services are appearing. But just to let you know, for example, yesterday I contacted them, I talked with them, and it turned out that they provide those loans just to people living in certain jurisdictions, so not to people living in all countries from in all places in the world, because they said that they are based in the United States and their jurisdictions prevent them or restricts them from providing loans to people living in certain parts of the world. And you have to check the list of the countries they are allowed to serve. So anyway, as a big when we have to realize that we're still in this early phase of development of the cryptocurrency use cases and, let's say, cryptocurrency world. So I think it is a step forward. So it is something really great that cryptocurrencies adoption is going deeper and deeper. And just to let you know, for example, let's switch to the Lightning Network. I'm very happy. So at the moment, the capacity of the Lightning Network is 775 BTC. So it has been constantly expanding. I'm really very happy, because I really hope that one day the Lightning Network will be able to solve the scalability issue of Bitcoin. And according to some other statistics, one of the biggest nodes within this Lightning network is, let me show it to you, it is AsynQ. It has 30 Bitcoins on the Lightning Network, so it is quite a significant node at the moment. And this is their site. Let me show you their site. This is the world map, and now the loading nodes list. We will see where in the world all these beautiful nodes are distributed. Just a second. So this is the map of the world according to this node AsynQ. Those are the nodes. You can see that most of the nodes are located on the east coast of the United States, and of course there are enough nodes on the west coast of the United States. There are also a lot of Lightning Network nodes in Canada at the moment, and also on the map we can see that there are many nodes in Europe. So it turned out that most of the nodes are either in North, in the United States and Canada, and in Europe. There are a couple of nodes, let's say, places in like Japan, Korea, New Zealand, but I see that most of the nodes are in the United States and in actually Europe. And I'm really very happy I checked some of the nodes in Europe. And just to let you know, I'm really very happy that in my small country that I used to live, we have a lot of nodes, for because we're really a very small country. The population of my country is approximately 6 to 7 millions, and probably less than 6 million, because most of the people from my country, they live within different places in Europe. But we have enough nodes for my small country, and I'm really very happy about this. So I see that there are many cryptocurrency enthusiasts in the place I used to live and in the place where I was born. And just to let you know, guys, the last thing I want to outline today is, if, for example, the Lightning Network and all these beautiful nodes are able to solve the scalability issue of Bitcoin, and if the price of Bitcoin start rising again, I think that we can reach, Bitcoin can reach really a very, very high price if compared to the current one. I mean, in the long run, let's say in 10 or 15 years. Just to remind you that the maximum supply for the Bitcoin is limited by 21 million. Most of you, of course, know this. So this is the maximum supply of Bitcoins, 21 million Bitcoins. It is in the long run. And this is how many dollars, US dollars, are circulating or have been printed and have been circulating and are circulating in the financial systems. According to the site of the Federal Reserve Bank of St. Louis. So at the moment we have almost 14.5 trillion US dollars circulating in the global financial system. And as you see, this chart has been going up and up, and I think that, let's say, in 10 years probably we will have approximately 21 trillion of US dollars, according to these statistics. And this is the monetary aggregate M2 money, stock or money supply. There is also M3, but I will not talk about it today. So let's say that in 10 years we have here approximately 21 trillion dollars. 21 trillion US dollars. And if in the long run Bitcoin is able to displace in the global financial system the United States, the US dollar, and if Bitcoin becomes a dominant currency in the world and replaces the US dollars, their prices will the amount of printed dollars will equal, let's say, the amount of Bitcoins in circulation. So let's say in this case 21 million Bitcoins will equal 21 trillion dollars, and in this case it means that one Bitcoin will be priced at the level of $1 million. So once again, if Bitcoin is able in a long run to displace or to replace from the US dollar, then we will see that the amount of Bitcoins, 21 million Bitcoins, will equal the amount or the value or the price of 21 trillion dollars, let's say in 10 or 15 years. And it means that one Bitcoin in this case may be priced at the level of $1 million. I know that at the moment it looks funny, but it is quite possible if Bitcoin community is able to solve the scalability issue and if Bitcoin remains the cryptocurrency king, at least in the let's say next 10 or 15 years. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. If you have some questions or ideas, please write down in the comments. Of course, I wish you a wonderful Friday and a beautiful weekend. Hope to see you in my next video and talk to you later. That was me at CryptoSpot. Thank you for watching, guys.